Hello everyone, another configuration from Laz for the CCNA, right? For CCNA and for many other things, right? Let's close that. All right, so we have two routers. Very difficult, very simple. I try to help you understand the concepts of it. PPP is very simple to do, all right? It's the frame relays out the window, MPLS is in, but PPP is still around. All right, but you need to do with serial cables. That's why I tell everybody that if they are buying live equipment or they're doing labs, use serial cables because more likely they will be in your certification. Real world, yes, everything's Ethernet. Okay, but let's get to it. All right, so this will be router one. Let's do this. Let's put this to one side. Whoops. Well, no, not that. Mouse has a life of its own. I've been hacked. Okay. There's somebody out there with nothing better to do. Okay. All right. Let's go here. All right. So we're going to say no, right, at the setup screen. We're going to enable this. We're going to config T. Now, when you're configuring PPP, in order to do that, you need to have a host name and you need to configure a DNS name. All right. You need to do this. Okay. Is it DNS also? No, I don't think so. Just a host name. Just a host name. And you'll see. All right, so we'll call this just host one. Host name, R1, I should say. R1. Let's put the IP address in. Int S0/0/0. IP address 10.1.1.5. You should know what this means. If not, you should get my book on Amazon, the only IP book you'll ever need. Okay, so you can submit just as quick. Clock rate. Why does this need a clock rate, boys and girls? Because this is the DCE portion of it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, our monthly salary. Hopefully, one day. All right, no shut. All right, do WR. Lovely. Now we go to the next router. And listen, don't get confused, okay? If that's confusing you here, I'm going to just get rid of this right here. R1 and R2. Okay. I've had people say, "Laz, it's confusing. The host name is this, and the label on the router says something else." So I don't want to confuse nobody. Okay. So here we go. So no. We're gonna enable config T, host name R2. Interface S0/0/0. Normally I will put S0/0, S001 is what I will put, but it don't matter. We don't need a clocker down here. This would be the DTE portion of the cable. All right, so we'll do IP address. 10.1.1.6, 255, 255, 255, 252. Oops, there we go. I'm going to put 5, but 2. Just want to erase that, but 2. Okay. No shot. There's no VR. Let's verify we can ping. Right now, ping. 10.1.1.5. And we can. Lovely. All right, one of the things that you want to see when you're using serial interface, let's say show interface S0/0/0. Okay. You see it's up. All right, you see right here already the bandwidth and all that. Hey, look, these are your K values. And then the encapsulation. By default, is HDLC. HDLC. All right, HDLC is proprietary. It's for each vendor. They have their own because they don't have no real layer 3 network protocols. So they put their own. So you cannot have a Cisco device and a non-Cisco device running HDLC. It will not work. All right. So we will want to use PPP. All right, so we're going to configure PPP so you can see what happens. Right now, everything's up and running, everything's working. We can do the show IP in brief, right? Up, no problem. So now what we're going to do is we're going to configure PPP. All right, we're going to do config T, interface S0/0/0. And if you don't know, the question mark, there's PPP right there. So PPP what? Okay, PPP authentication, CHAP, PAP. Almost, okay. NCAP, sorry, PPP. All right. Look what it says. Change state to down. I got ahead of myself. Change state to down. So it's not working. And we're going to do the authentication as well. PPP, authentication, CHAP, and PAP. Why both last? If one fails, you got another one. One's plain text, one's encrypted. Okay. But here's the key. You need to put a username and password. Now, this is not for you to log in. This is for the router. So you're going to go username, the host name of your neighbor, R1, password, Cisco. All this is case sensitive, ladies and gentlemen. All of it. Okay? So let's see what happens now. All right, let's see what's going on here. Show IP in brief. Up, down. Why? Because one's running PPP and one's running HDLC. It's not going to work. Okay, well, that's an easy fix, right? We go to the other router. I mean, the interface already is the only one interface I'm in, so I'm going to do PPP NCAP. Okay, PPP. Right, is PPP in here? Yes, okay. PPP NCAP. Really? Oh, NCAP, no. Yes, sorry. NCAP, PPP, sorry. Backwards. All right. It didn't come up? Oh, I know. It's off the authentication. PPP, not POP, PPP, authentication, CHAP, PAP. Now it should come up. We should see something coming up really soon here. Nothing came up yet. Nothing came up yet. That's weird. Let's take a look and see what's going on. Let's take a look. Show interface S0/0/0. And we see this. The encapsulation is PPP, but we see the link control protocol because it uses link control protocol and network control protocol, all right, in order to make the connection. And you see everything is closed. It's not working. Why? Because we haven't created the username. They can authenticate to each other. Oh, okay. Username, router 2. Password must be identical, Cisco. Oh, it will help if I'm in config T. Username, R2, password, Cisco. Okay, sure. Is anything going to come up now? Boom! There it is. Okay, well, let's check it. Do show interface S0/0. Oops. One more zero. And there we go. The link control protocol is open. So it's IPCP and CDPCP. And now we can ping again. 10.1.1.6. Do ping. Remember where you're at. When you're doing things, you don't go crazy. Oh my God, I can't ping. Okay. And there you are. That's it. Simple as that. And if you were to do a show start, you see that you have the use, where is it? Okay. There's a username right there. Okay, username R2, password Cisco. This zero just means that it's plain text. And over here, and let's show start. And there you see username R1, password plain text Cisco. So same is case sensitive, has to be the same password. Okay, and you're using the host name of the other router. All right. But other than that, there's nothing to it. It's just putting in the type of encapsulation and then the authentication. And this needs to be in the same order. Okay? That's it. That's all there is to PPP. So if you're both Cisco routers, if you're both Dell routers, if you're both F5 routers, if you're both routers of the same manufacturer, yeah, you can HDLC all the way. If you're not, then you need to use PPP because it's for everyone, okay? Not just, you know, a particular vendor, all right? So PPP has a lot more features, but if you want to learn about all that stuff, go to globeg.net, all right? Take a look at the complete course, all right? It's there. It goes, it dives in a little bit, it dives a lot deeper than we do here, and you get a better explanation. It'll get you ready for your certification. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and please like it and give me feedback. All right. I hope you enjoyed it. This is simple. This is PPP. See you in the next one.